Hagamos que esta relación a distancia sea fácil.
Te llamaré todas las mañanas.
Ha entrado en la escuela de jóvenes actores. Es algo increíble, pero Ricky también es increíble, así que...
I'm Jesús from a cartelera, Spain, and it's really nice to talk to you. I loved season one and I can't wait to see season two. My first question is about how you were one of the first Disney Plus original shows, and a lot has happened since that D23 Expo in 2019. So I'd like to know how has been for you these months when you had maybe to leave the reaction of the fans from your home without being able to really feeling like a normal time.
Totally. First of all, I want to say that your smile is infectious. Just want to make sure you knew that. Like, you literally made me smile. You're so awesome.
Thank you.
But, I was going to say, yeah, I mean, it was kind of scary, I think. And not really scary, but kind of exciting being like one of the, like literally one of the very few shows that the network was launching with. But we were really fortunate to have a really great team behind us, and Disney was so supportive and really held our hands the whole way and just gave us so many wonderful things. And so I was never worried. I knew we were in good hands, you know. It's like not a bad company to be with. So once everything came out, it was sort of just like we were just watching it snowball and snowball and snowball. And then even when the pandemic hit, like the audience has like doubled since then, because people just had time to sort of, you know, sit home and watch and catch up on stuff. So it's been cool to like see the trajectory of it. And I think now it's like built all this anticipation, and people are waiting for so long for season two that I can't wait to like hit the ground running on May 14th. So I'm very excited to see season two.
Yeah, I agree. I think, and kind of like you said, keeping attached to, you know, people and still staying involved with the fan base over kind of quarantine period and throughout 2020 when things, you know, kind of were starting to go to a new normal. I think what was still super fun through that was we got to do the holiday special, which was still kind of almost like a, you know, a little gapping, you know, like bridging the gap, I guess, between season one and season two. And, you know, still giving people something to enjoy that was still related to the show and still, you know, all of that, but also getting to know us more personally, I think was super fun because, you know, in the show, you don't get to know us, you get to know the characters. Even though we do have like some BTS stuff on there, I think the holiday special was super fun for people to get to know us. And then, you know, social media, like interacting with people on social media is always great. And I think is a great way to connect with fans of the show.
Going into season two, Matt, I'd like to start with you. So EJ is in a different position than the others in his high. So what can you tell me about this special moment for him and this time of change that he's dealing with, and what can we expect for these episodes and maybe the future of the show?
Yeah, I think he's definitely in a really, really big time of change. I think he's trying to kind of figure himself out and figure out what's important to him. And being that he's a second semester senior, he's trying to kind of figure out what's next. You know, like, is that college? Is that, you know, like go get a job somewhere? Is that like what do I do? You know, he wants to impress his family. Like he has a, you know, long line of history with his family going to a very specific school. And you know, he wants to follow in that line and just kind of impress his family. But also trying to figure out what's important to him. And I think he starts to realize that, you know, this group of people that he has around him is super important, and they've taught him so much about just being yourself and being true to yourself. You don't have to put on this fake facade of being the perfect person. And I think that's, you know, really great for him to kind of grow into that and realize that, like, everything I have is right here. I have my group of people that I love and that love me, and that's what's important.
And Joshua, Ricky has a lot on his plate this season with Nini leaving, with his situation in with his family and with the musical. So I'd like to know, what was the one thing that you were most looking forward to deal with your character in this season?
Yeah, I think it's always interesting seeing like the stuff that they throw at Ricky, just because he just is always falling on his face, you know, like always has something happen. But yeah, I mean, he really has to grow up, and I can relate to that, like in terms of my own life. When I was like 16, there was a lot of fundamental changes that were happening in my life that forced me to grow up very fast. And I think that that's kind of what Ricky's going through now. And so it's almost like therapeutic to sort of go back and play that in a safe space and like know how it ends, you know, because when you're 16, you don't know how it ends. And so it feels like the end of the world. But, you know, I think it's just like, it's cool to play a character that I think a lot of people can relate to, and I personally relate to, and it's just very authentic and real. And I think it's important for people to see that on screen, you know, like, and feel the comfort that, you know, they're not alone in whatever they're going through. So, you know, there's lots of twists and turns this season, but Ricky's always fun to play, and they did some brilliant work with the writing this season, as well as the first, but, you know, they definitely home run season two.
Yeah, focusing on the Nini part of your story, I found really surprising that the show is taking one of the stars outside its height so quickly. So how is she going to be present in the school while not being there during the season? Is she going to be as present as the others with her role?
Absolutely. Yeah. No. Yeah. I mean, it might seem on the outside like you know, Nini is, there's stuff happening, but definitely watch the show and it'll all sort of make sense. That's all I can really say. But, you know, I think Nini's figuring out her own path right now, and she's sort of figuring out her own thing. And so you kind of need that time, because that's just how you know, how it goes in life. And so, yeah, she's on her own trajectory and doing her thing, but people will be pleasantly surprised, I think, with how it all sort of comes out.
And focusing on the musical part of the season, I really loved how the characters react to the news that the musical isn't going to be High School Musical 2, but Beauty and the Beast. How did you react as actors when they told you are doing a legendary musical and Disney classic the size of Beauty and the Beast?
I think we probably reacted pretty similarly to the way our characters reacted. Like, we were all so excited because, you know, it is such a legendary, you know, Disney movie. And we were all so excited to get to do the music from it, and also get to, like, you know, find out who's playing who. And I think that's like a super, super interesting, fun part that I think fans are gonna love so much, is just getting to see who's playing who in Beauty and the Beast. And, you know, certain ones may surprise you, certain ones may not surprise you, but I think it's gonna be super, super fun and people are gonna love it.
A good anecdote for the season, it's funny, it's, you know, season one was High School Musical. My first musical ever when I was 7 was High School Musical. So that was pretty full circle. And season 2 is Beauty and the Beast. And Olivia's first ever musical was Beauty and the Beast when she was pretty young. So it's pretty cool how that, like, sort of works out like that. I don't know. Whatever Matt's first show is will probably be season 3 at this point.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, Matt, what was your first musical?
my first show was Wizard of Oz, so we'll see.
Oh!
We'll see.
Whoa, yeah, I'm texting Tim right now.
Honestly?
No, it would be really great, eh? Yeah. Noted. About the original music in the show, I'd like to know what can we expect in season 2. And I also wanted to know, the stars of the original movies got to go on tour with the music of the movies. Have you ever talked or dreamed about it? I know it's difficult because of the situation, but have you ever talked about maybe going on tour, maybe going on a worldwide tour with the songs of the show?
That's the dream, dude, for real. Like, ideally, we go to Spain at end of the year, you know? Well, I don't know. We'll see. But I think, you know, the thing about this show that really does make it special is the music. And at the end of filming season 2, we all got together as a cast to watch all the songs and dances from the season. And it was such a beautiful night that I'll never forget. It was crying and cheering and laughing and dancing and all the in-betweens, you know? Like, we really, like, it really impacted me watching all the music back-to-back, let alone, like, all the scenes and everything else in the middle, but we just watched all the numbers. So I think that people are really going to walk away with this season with a new favorite season of television and a new favorite playlist, because it really is, like, such a special season. And I'm, like, just getting super excited just thinking about it.
It's been really, really great talking to you today. And again, I can't wait to see the new episodes. Congratulations again for the show.
Thank you, dude. Much. You rock. Thanks.
Have a nice day. Thanks.
Take care.
Os necesitamos a todos. Que gane el mejor instituto. Abrochaos los cinturones. Esta fiesta solo acaba de empezar.